Getting tired of that cloud cover yet? We've been stuck with it for the last few days or so. Kind of looks more like Seattle out there. We're just seeing cloud cover around mid-60s for that reason. If we get enough sunshine, we would see those temps easily jump into the 70s, and I think we will a little later this afternoon, but so far, we're not quite there yet. A little cooler off to the north. Fort Dodge, just 57 degrees, 66 here, 63 in Ames, and 63 in Lamoni as well. Ottumwa looks about the same this hour. Notice that the cloud cover has been back and forth. It's filled back in over the last couple of hours. We had a little sunshine. That bubbled up a few more clouds, and now we're stuck with a few right now as well. We'll still see some sunshine this afternoon, but we are going to be battling the clouds, it looks like, for the day. Off to the east, we look off and see what's left of Andrea. It's still a tropical storm. Sustained winds around 46 miles per hour. Does keep it at tropical storm status. And this is moving northeast at about 25 miles per hour. So this will continue to impact the east coast. If you've got a flight up towards New England here over the next 24 hours, you will get impacted by this. This is just going to kind of hug the coast. So that means it will continue to pump in a lot of moisture with this, 2 to 5 inches of rainfall possible as it does continue to work its way to the north and east. We're watching a different system off to the north and west. Doesn't look real impressive right now, but you'll notice as you head up into parts of Montana, you're seeing some showers associated with it. Into Colorado, there's some moisture building down there as well. And that's all going to be sliding towards us, but it's not going to really impact us for another 24 to 36 hours or so, it looks like, as we head towards late Saturday and into early Sunday. We'll bring that chance for some showers and a few storms in the forecast. Let's time it out with Futurecast. 7 p.m. today, we're dry. Still some clouds out there, a few peaks of sunshine. Those should break up tonight. We likely start out with some sunshine on Saturday. Really looks like a nice start to the day. The first half, in fact, watch us time it out towards noon. Still completely dry in central Iowa. Showers over towards Council Bluffs. Let's move it forward, stopping at around 2 p.m. Notice we're still dry here. Showers just off to the west over towards maybe Carroll County, west of there. And then as we head towards about 3-4 p.m., our computer models try to bring in at least a slight chance for some light rain by mid to late afternoon. But notice the yellows. That's where any thunderstorm and lightning activity would be. Still well to our west around 4 p.m. That doesn't arrive until closer to probably 6 or 7 p.m. So there may be some rain before that, but it looks like the heavier rain and the potential for some storms probably going to be closer to the evening hours. And then overnight through the overnight hours of Saturday, we'll keep those in the forecast before it moves out early Sunday. We may see some redevelopment Sunday afternoon. So slight risk for severe storms. Again, this is for late Saturday into Saturday night, mostly after about 4 or 5 p.m. Temperatures today, upper 60s to low 70s. We'll shoot for about 72 here. Mix of clouds and sunshine. Tonight's low, 54. We'll call it partly cloudy. 8-day forecast, 76 tomorrow. Again, beautiful half of the day for the first half at least. Second half could get a little wet, could see some storms as well. And Sunday, it looks like we'll probably start out dry and end up with a few showers bubbling up late in the day. And then we may actually see some 80s around here next week. With that warmth and moisture comes a couple more thunderstorm chances.
Of course. All right.
It's always something, isn't
you
it?
You had to add that, didn't you? You could have just stopped.
It's
but
in
no.
there.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Wes.